News leader. Eyewitness News at Noon starts now.
Online through midnight. And also this noon, we want to make sure you know about another free opportunity for parents who want to know more about autism. There's a free autism workshop that's coming up next Saturday, the 21st, at the Behavior Analysis Center for Autism in Fishers. That's where Carl Sundberg works, and he joins us now live to talk about autism and some of the many, many challenges for parents. And thank you for joining us today. So autism, it seems like its prevalence just continues to increase. Why is that?
Yes, it does. Many theories regarding the increased numbers in autism. There's not really a known reason for the increase, and much of it, I believe, is due to change in diagnosis and awareness. More kids are getting diagnosed with autism than they used to be. There are theories such as a vaccination, but there's no real evidence to support that. So it's kind of unknown.
And there is quite a spectrum, from a little bit to a lot, but parents really do get frustrated and seek treatment. And what are some of the things and some of the therapies that people are, parents are seeking out for their kids when they have an autistic child?
Well, there are thousands of treatments that are touted to cure or alleviate autism. Unfortunately, very few have scientific data to back them up. And I do recommend that you do the research. The therapies that do have the most research applied behavior analysis. 70 years of research to back that up. But there are also other therapies. There's the diet. There's chelation. There's some very odd therapies that parents try as a magic pill. Swimming with dolphins, secretin injections, so on and so forth. But I can tell you, swimming with a dolphin, a child may appreciate that and it might be fun, but it's not going to cure autism.
Well, and tell me about this applied behavior analysis, because I know that really is your life's work.
Yes,
what is it? How is it different?
Okay. Applied behavior analysis is the science of human behavior. And it was started by B.F. Skinner over 70 years ago, and it's based on 70 years of research and data. And if you understand applied behavior analysis, you can understand the causes of human behavior. If you understand that and you use that to apply to children with autism, you can have a lot of success teaching children. And it's no secret. It's hard work, and it requires a skilled team of therapists to carry out. It's the basis is it involves breaking down skills, identifying skill deficits, breaking them down into the smallest manageable units, and then through the procedures of behavior analysis, building upon those skills into more functional measures, more functional units. It's intensive. It's up to 40 hours a week. Autism is 24/7. Needs to be treated. Typical children have thousands and thousands, perhaps 20,000 learning opportunities in a day. They learn from their natural environment, everything. Children with autism don't learn that way. They need a very carefully arranged environment to learn.
And they need support.
A lot of support.
Is there a cure?
That, most of my colleagues would say there is no cure for autism. People talk about finding a cure for autism. To me, that's not the main question or of main importance to me. You can alleviate the symptoms in some cases, and you can improve the symptoms. If you have a child that cannot communicate, now you teach them to communicate, does that child still have autism? I say that child's performing better and functioning better.
Yeah, you can measure some progress there. And then just finally, what would be your advice to the public when they're encountering a parent with a child with autism? Because I know that can be so frustrating, and there seems to be a lack of understanding of your empathy for the situation the child's in.
I'd say get started right away. Research. Be very careful about alternative therapies and all of the therapies, and get started. Seek some advice right away. Talk to your doctor and get an assessment as soon as possible.
All right. Diagnosis is the start.
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
Thanks for joining us today. And the conversation will continue next week. Again, the information for that workshop is in Fishers. It is the 21st at the Behavior Analysis Center for Autism. That's located on 126th Street. This is free to parents, and there is a small fee for caregivers to attend. So that's the latest on the Health Beat today, Scott. A lot of opportunities for people to learn more about their health, make it a priority, and take some action. Back to you.
All right, Ann, thanks. The blowing and drifting snow, a big story for us today.